see how you do under pressure. This is Harry Judd for Boxing Now, formerly BBTV. Delighted to be joined by Callum Simpson. Massive event tonight for the amateur game. Handing out awards, is that what you're doing tonight?
Yeah, obviously I just come to show my support to local amateurs, the amateurs, and then also, yeah, I believe I'm handing out the Spotlight Award later on tonight, yeah.
You spent a lot of time, obviously, in the amateurs, Trevor Schofield Barnsley Star. Just talk to me about those days, because, you know, you started boxing, 9 years old?
Yeah, started boxing at 9 years old. I had 50, obviously, at Barnsley Star ABC, I had 53 fights with them guys. I had 53 fights with Barnsley Star, and yeah, I can still remember my dad taking me down to the gym, and I met John Sager, Trevor Schofield, Pete Cullen there as well, and yeah, amazing people. They've been a massive part of my boxing career, and I wouldn't be where I am now without them guys. But yeah, I can just think the smell of the gym, going into the gym, and all that. They took me up and down the country sparring and fighting, so yeah, I owe a lot to them guys, yeah.
You posted a social media post today, before and now. Talk to me about that clip, because it must take you back to when you first started boxing, mate.
Yeah, that video from was becoming Working Men's Club, and it's just a little memory of, you know, nothing's changed really. You know, nothing's changed. I'm still training hard, still committed to it. It'd be just getting a few more rewards for it now, that's it really. But yeah, it's always nice to look back, and kind of a lot of people, like since I signed with Sky as well, a lot of people on the side hearing about me over the last 12 months,
yeah, yeah.
And you know, I've been doing well with Boxer and Sky, but I've been doing this for the past 18 years, yeah. most of my life, but a lot of people don't see that, so it's nice to just share, you know, a little old school video, and people might be like, oh, actually I've been doing this for a long time. Oh yeah,
yeah, like I said, you're getting more and more well known. Obviously you've got a hell of a fan base up there in Barnsley. The promotion or the press conference, the other week, just talk me through that. I spoke to you off camera now. Did you expect? I mean, it's a hell of a lot of people.
Yeah, definitely. You know, Boxer told me they wanted to do a press conference in like a sports bar. So as I said, oh, let's do it in the Garrison. And they limited me. They said, oh, I can only have 50 people. And I was like, I need more than 50. Like, even like close friends, I need more than 50. Because it's one of them where you don't invite one person, they'll kick off big time. So, I weren't surprised at all. Literally, I messaged them all the day before saying, go to this press conference tomorrow. I'd love you to be there. You're a part of my journey. And everyone that I asked were turned up. They all got the red, the Team Simpson colours, the bands of colours. And yeah, everyone turn up and to support me, yeah.
Obviously knee deep now in training, just let me know, how's it going?
Going really well. I've been over in Bolton today sparring Boris Crichton, and actually another lad called Ryan, who's actually doing very well. It's Scottish things, like a Scottish national champion, and he just beat a lad called Tegan Scott in the national championships as well, so he's very good as well. But yeah, so I did 12 rounds with them two today. I actually fought Boris as well, like three fights ago, with my former opponent, so it was good to share the ring with him again.
Is it hard not to get too involved in the promotion of it? Obviously, this is a homecoming fight, been lots of publicity over it with a massive, massive Barnsley crowd. Is it quite hard to remain sort of cautious before the big night?
Not really, you know, I think I'm a very relaxed, chill person. I don't let anything get to my head. You know, I think maybe some people might get a bit too excited, but you know, like I said, I'm very level-headed. Got a good head on my shoulders, and yeah, I take it all in my stride. I'm just enjoying it, to be honest, mate. Just enjoying the journey, you know. Soaking it all up and getting training very, very hard as well. So I'm too tired from training to be able to get too excited, mate, to be honest.
You're up against Zak Cheli, who does. I mean, you are, you know, so, you know, calm, cool, and collective. Zak will try and get under your skin. What do you expect on fight week?
If he tries it, mate, good luck to him. You know, listen, I've got a brother that, I've got seven brothers and sisters. My closest brother's about the age is 15 months older than me. So anyone that knows what it's like to a big brother, the amount of winding up I used to get when I was younger, I think I'm built up a very bigger tolerance and a thick skin. So yeah, listen, no one in this world can get under my skin, definitely not.
Are you expecting to be hostile towards Zak?
I don't know. I think it's called those Barnsley lot riffraffs, and so there's nothing to do in Barnsley. Not said great things about Barnsley, to be honest. So if it carries on, then it might be a bit hostile. But you know, us Northern lot, we're nice people. So I don't think it'll be too hostile for him. We'll see. Depends how he's on fight week. If he wants to try and show off and give it big, and then it might be hostile. We'll see.
What do you think of him anyway?
in boxing sense or
both? Or? Both? Give me both.
He's an alright lad, to be honest, mate. I don't mind him. You know, I met him quite a few times, boxed on the same undercard before. Shared a taxi back to the hotel with his dad and himself after the weigh-in. You know, I had a few conversations. They actually wanted to fight him when he had the English title and we were trying to get it sorted.
Yeah.
But then obviously he lost to Jeffers. He's a sound kid. I think he's a little bit arrogant and a little bit delusional, but he's a nice lad. He's just, I don't know. But then boxing ability. He's got his strengths, so you know he's strong, he's fit, he's got a good mentality, very confident. But I think he lacks actual boxing ability. I think his biggest strength is probably his awkwardness, to be honest. But yeah, we prepared very well for him. There's gonna be no issues there at all.
Less than a month away, finally, message to your fans before the big night.
Yeah, big thank you to everyone that's come out to support me. You know, the show sold out in 48 hours. Did record-breaking pre-sales, sign-up. So yeah, I'm not gonna let you down. I'm gonna put on a good show, and I hope you all have a great night. It's gonna be an amazing event in Barnsley.
Callum, absolute pleasure, mate. Yeah, let's see how you do.